In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of latissimus dorsi. This is very big shoulder muscle on posterior part of back. I'm going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and important connection with core muscle. So let me explain origin first. Origin is basically this part, okay? It originates from T7 through T12. T7 through T12 and all the way down to sacrum, but via fascia. Via this fascia. This fascia is thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia. It's very broad fascia on back part of body. I'm going to explain detail about this fascia later, so please remember this fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia. Okay, this fascia continues to here, sacrum. So you can say latissimus dorsi originates from T7 to all the way down to sacrum. Okay, next one is here, posterior part of iliac crest. Iliac crest, right here. So basically from pelvis. Next one is rib 7 through rib 12, about this area. Rib 7 through rib 12, okay? And one more place, which is here. This is inferior angle of scapula. Inferior angle. Oh my gosh, that's a lot, right? T7 to sacrum. Iliac crest. Thoracolumbar fascia. Rib 7 through 12. Inferior angle. That's a lot of origin. Okay. Now let me explain insertion. Insertion is on humerus, particularly on anterior part. This place is intertubercular groove. Intertubercular groove or sulcus. This name, this terminology depends on anatomy book. Some books might say intertubercular groove, or some other books might say intertubercular sulcus. But it means same thing. It's on humerus, particularly on anterior part. This muscle is only muscle that originates from core, pelvis, then it inserts to humerus. That means this muscle has important role for shoulder movement and core stability. Very important muscle. So let me explain its function. This muscle can do basically four movements for shoulder. Main movement is extension. Very strong shoulder extensor. Latissimus dorsi works when you pull shoulder backward. Very strong, okay? Extension. And adduction. Shoulder adduction. This muscle activates when you do chin up, okay? That's very strong extension and slight adduction, right? This muscle is the chin up muscle. Okay, these are two. What about other two movements? Third one is internal rotation. It's a little bit weird, isn't it? Because latissimus dorsi is on back part of body. How come this muscle can do internal rotation? Think about insertion. Insertion is on anterior part of humerus. So there's like a spiral orientation of muscle. You see, right here. So there's spiral orientation. Thus, this vector brings humerus to internal rotation. Does it make sense? One last movement is horizontal abduction. Horizontal abduction is when you raise arm about 90 degrees, then you pull shoulder backward. It's like a butterfly movement. Okay, it's opposite movement from dumbbell fly. By the way, dumbbell fly movement is horizontal adduction. Okay, dumbbell fly is horizontal adduction. Horizontal abduction is opposite from dumbbell fly movement. That's what latissimus dorsi does. Horizontal abduction. Okay, these are four movements which latissimus dorsi does. Extension, pulling movement, adduction, internal rotation, and horizontal abduction. Then, do you remember this muscle originates from rib cage? That means latissimus dorsi can assist breathing. It's not priority, but it's kind of assistant breathing muscle. Okay, breathing. Now, let me explain important core connection about this muscle. Do you remember this muscle originates from thoracolumbar fascia? Okay, this is thoracolumbar fascia. This is key point of core muscle connection. How come? Okay, there is transverse abdominis deep to latissimus dorsi. This is latissimus dorsi. This is transverse abdominis. Transverse abdominis kind of fuse to thoracolumbar fascia. Okay. Transverse abdominis fuses to fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia, right? Thus, you can say latissimus dorsi and transverse abdominis are connected via thoracolumbar fascia. Can you imagine that? This is thoracolumbar fascia, right? Deep to latissimus dorsi and other core muscles, there is transverse abdominis. So, if you can use latissimus dorsi very well, that you can stimulate transverse abdominis. What is important about transverse abdominis? This muscle is freaking important for core stability. So if you can use latissimus dorsi nicely, that can indirectly affect transverse abdominis. That can lead to good core stability. I explain that again. There is thoracolumbar fascia and latissimus dorsi here. Deep to that, this is transverse abdominis. These two muscles are indirectly connected by fascia. If you can stimulate latissimus dorsi, you can stimulate transverse abdominis via thoracolumbar fascia. So activation of latissimus dorsi is important for core stability. Does it make sense? Let me explain more detail about core connection. This is deep core muscles. Imagine there is transverse abdominis. Basically, three muscles are connected to transverse abdominis. This is quadratus lumborum. Quadratus lumborum. This is psoas. And this is diaphragm. Diaphragm. These guys are important for core stabilities. and core movement. Again, imagine there is latissimus dorsi or backside of body. If this muscle is stimulated nicely, transverse abdominis is activated. Imagine there is transverse abdominis. If you can use transverse abdominis, you can use diaphragm, psoas, and quadratus lumborum. Thus, latissimus dorsi is important for core stability. It's not only shoulder muscle, but also for core muscle. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.